Dear students, good morning. Today we are going to see endocrine glands. What are endocrine glands? Endocrine glands are ductless glands which pour their secretions directly into the bloodstream. The endocrine glands are pituitary, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, pancreas, suprarenal or adrenal gland, testis in male and ovary in female. Pituitary gland, it is a small peanut shaped gland situated in the hypophyseal fossa or cella turcica. It is attached to the base of the brain by a stalk known as infundibulum. Parts. It consists of anterior lobe and a posterior lobe. The anterior lobe is otherwise known as adenohypophysis and the posterior lobe is otherwise known as neurohypophysis. There is a gap or the space between the two lobes known as residual lumen. Between the anterior lobe and the residual lumen, this area is known as the intermediate lobe of the pituitary gland. The adenohypophysis near the infundibulum presents an elevation known as pars tuberalis. The gland is situated in the pituitary fossa, cella turcica. It is covered by a fold of dura mater known as diaphragma cellae. Development. It develops from rachis pouch. Blood supply. It is supplied by superior and inferior hypophyseal arteries. Next one, thyroid gland. It is a head-shaped gland and it is the largest endocrine gland, present on the anterior and the lateral aspect of the neck. It consists of two lobes connected by isthmus. Each lobe has an apex, a base, a medial border and three surfaces. The isthmus has superior and inferior border and two surfaces, anterior and posterior surface. On the superior border of the isthmus, there is a slight projection on the left side of the isthmus known as pyramidal lobe. Situation. See, it is an easy way to remember the situation. The thyroid gland is situated at the level of C5, C6, C7 and first thoracic vertebra. That is from 5th cervical, 6th cervical, 7th cervical and first thoracic vertebra. Whereas the isthmus is present at the level of 2nd, 3rd and 4th tracheal rings. This is in case of the level of the vertebra, this is in case of the tracheal rings. Okay. Then it is covered by a fascia. Okay, that is a capsule. And okay, it consists of two capsules. One is true capsule, which is adherent to the surface of the gland. And the false capsule is the pretracheal fascia, which encloses the gland. This is the fascia, which is responsible for the movement of the gland during deglutition in the condition called goiter. You can see the enlarged gland movement. Okay, next one. Blood supply consists of superior and inferior thyroid arteries. These arteries supply the blood supply to the gland. Histology or the structure of thyroid gland. It consists of number of lobules or lobes. Number of lobes. Okay, known as follicle. The follicles are lined by cuboidal epithelium. The follicles are lined by cuboidal epithelium. Inside the follicle, there is a substance known as colloid. It is the inactive form of the thyroid hormone, that is the T3 hormone is present inside the follicle. Okay, development. It develops from median thyroid diverticulum. Next one is suprarenal gland. It is a paired endocrine gland situated one on upper pole of each kidney. This is the lower pole of the kidney, this is the upper pole of the kidney. So one on upper pole of each kidney. The right suprarenal gland is pyramidal in shape, whereas the left suprarenal gland is semilunar in shape. Each gland has an apex, a base, a medial border, and three surfaces. It is covered by renal fascia, that is a capsule. Next, blood supply. It is supplied by superior, middle, and inferior suprarenal arteries. Histology of the structure of suprarenal gland. It has an outer fibrous capsule covering. Okay. The parenchyma is made up of outer cortex and inner medulla. The cortex contains three groups of cells. The outermost layer is the zona glomerulosa, which is made up of flask-shaped cells. The middle layer is zona fasciculata. It is made up of polyhedral cells arranged in a longitudinal manner. The zona reticularis contains rounded cells. Okay, and then the medulla. The medulla contains group of cells. Okay, circular cells with numerous blood vessels and nerves. Development. The cortex develops from the mesoderm. During embryological development, you have read ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. So the cortex develops from the mesoderm, whereas the medulla develops from neural crest cells. Pancreas, okay, it is a fleshy J-shaped gland or retort-shaped gland situated on the posterior abdominal wall. General features. It is a retroperitoneal organ. It is the only gland which is both exocrine and endocrine in nature. Location, where it is situated. It extends from the concavity of the duodenum to the hilum of spleen. Lies opposite to the level of T12, L1, L2 and L3 vertebrae. Parts. It consists of head. This area is the head. And this constricted portion is the neck, and this is the body and tail. It has two processes. One is in the present in the head known as uncinate process, and one in the body known as tuber omentae, which is lateral to the left side of the neck of the pancreas. Pancreatic duct. The pancreatic duct begins from the tail, travels through the whole length of the gland, where it joins with the common bile duct to form ampulla of water. The ampulla of water or hepatopancreatic duct opens into the second part of duodenum. There is accessory pancreatic duct. If it is present, it starts from the head and it may join either in the main pancreatic duct or ampulla of Vater. Okay, the pancreatic duct is otherwise known as duct of Wilson. Blood supply. The pancreas is supplied by splenic artery, superior pancreatico-duodenal artery and inferior pancreatico-duodenal artery. Venous drainage, that is the splenic vein, superior pancreatico-duodenal vein, inferior pancreatico-duodenal vein. These drains into portal vein. Development. It develops from the ventral and dorsal pancreatic buds. Okay. Histology or the structure of the gland. The structure of the gland contains, okay, since it is an exocrine and endocrine gland, you have two parts. One is pancreatic acinus, which is an exocrine part, and islets of Langerhans, which is endocrine part. The pancreatic acinus. Acini means containing group of cells. So pancreatic acinus contains pancreatic acini or acinar cells. Okay, and with zymogen granules. Whereas the islets of Langerhans contains alpha, beta and delta cells.